I was sort of encouraged by that. So I've asked Kati to just sort of call in the four groups and help keep things moving and call on people. So Kati Kerner from Lincoln Center Theater is going to take it on again from here. So
who's
going to be Kati?
Yes, Kati.
Can we just go around? But you've had a designated note taker. Can you just sort of talk about what the things you that sort of came up for you? Literally, it's lots of stuff. And if there are questions about something, then feel free to ask or clarify. Or sometimes, you know, when you have such an intense discussion and it's hard to sort of synthesize, and then everybody feels like, I think I understand, but I'm not quite sure. So we have a little like 45 minutes, and we should feel free to ask each other questions. So should we start over here with the internal?
Jessica,
have your
seat.
Jessica,
we want to talk to
you.
No,
you want to do it together?
Yeah, do it together. And then we mentioned that there are new buzzwords
to move from departments into an institutional plan. There are some ideas around how to do that.
Oh, and we should take time to talk to those that give us support and ideas. You know, go have a meal or at least remember to find and refill our cups. I think that was expected.
Yep. Are there any questions for the
Sorry, yep. And what were some of those ideas for how the education department would advocate for equity, diversity, inclusion?
Somebody said have a summit.
Yes, it was her speech was supposed to summit. That's sort of the
Thanks, right. Jenny.
But apparently worked very well for you. But bringing the national idea, the national conversation, I think, to the organization and its board. There was a resource book for the organization to help build a common language and a common vocabulary, and just like and viewing the creation of a plan as a process, an ongoing process that has to kind of stay a process.
Theater leverage what schools are already doing and are committed to. I think that was a common thing. Is kind of don't go in. If we think of the research on cultural responsiveness, right, it's actually not about a race or ethnicity, it's about cultures. Schools already have a culture and you're walking into an existing culture and you want to be part of that culture and contribute to it. What's already happening in the school learning, but also find out what's the school culture like that you're going into. You should never kind of think of, we've got something great that's going to enlighten your kids. You can't wait. It's got to be a partnership. Communication with administration. Several things here, circle time for relationship building, time for planning, time for professional development. And that's a PD of the host teachers as well as ideally the leadership of that school. Spending time with them, really taking the time to just communicate what you want. Trying to help for the kids. Focusing also not just on kind of arts integration and how you can do STEAM, but theater for theater's sake and the value of theater for conflict resolution and empathy and all the things that I shared is now being on the inside of the school system. Principals at the end of the day are teachers, they're educators. They want the same thing we want, right? They just have so much stuff piled on them. Reminding them why they're in it. Not in a condescending way, but in a welcoming way. Just the same way you might want to talk to your artistic directors, you know, in terms of that. All kids are at risk. Understanding the backgrounds of different communities, urban, suburban, rural, shelter. How much time do you have to spend with the kids? This was one of the colleagues brought up. You know, why has 10 weeks become the thing, or 12 weeks, or 8 sessions, or is 4 too little, and 16 too much? We talked about working backwards. If you're putting on a show, and how much time do you have? Think like that. What's your residency going to be? What can you do, what can't you do? Are we actually enhancing the learning? Collaborate and reiterate what classrooms are working on. Provide resources and opportunities for more meaningful engagement. This speaks for itself. Maneuvering multiple districts and preconceived notions of the other. I don't know what that was about. Who said that one? The other?
That often when you're working in different school districts, we were talking about the example of St. Louis that has over 94 school districts in the area. When you're working with lots of different communities, especially if you're trying to get them to work with each other and understand each other, figuring out what are your policies when you're working with different groups of people, and how can you break down those preconceived notions that they might have about each other.
Teacher and administration buy-in, collaboration and planning. This came up several times. Should never be kind of telling the administrator, we've got this great residency for you, and then day one you show up. There's got to be planning time with the teacher, dedicated time. Sounds like a no-brainer, but it shouldn't just be, you know, Mr. and Mrs. Teacher, this is what we're going to do. But it's kind of finding out even what their teaching style is like. Are they very verbal? Are they on their feet? Do they like to do their things? How can you, I call it vaudeville, right? How can you team teach with them? As one of our colleagues said, they shouldn't be in the back drinking a coffee, smoking a cigarette anymore, but drinking a coffee or interrupting you for discipline issues. They should be there as kind of ideally a partner, but at least kind of maybe a colleague. And we talked about the professional development built in. Ideally, you should be kind of giving them some chops so that they can do it in the between time when you're not there. It's not about the money. It's okay to walk away. If this is, the principal says, I want to you to use puppetry to teach the digestive tract, and that happened to me at a theater. I said, but we do Shakespeare. Being able to walk away from a program and say, it's not integral to what we do. This is what we do. We'd love to do it with you, but that's not who we are. It's not accountability. We support, not relieve or replace the classroom education. We have organized ambiguity is okay, meaning that the principal might come in and think it's chaos. I call it organized ambiguity. So the idea of kind of letting them know what they're going to see if they walk in. Relationship building, language accessibility. And then the last one that came up was thinking about contracts or agreements with the school, whether it's a full contract or just a little statement of writing, but a prenup to articulate expectations, quantifiable value to the work, including all parties in that conversation. And then the last one was just the idea that I know that Roundabout Theater does, and that I used to do, is if you are working in multiple schools in your city or rural county, do you have some kind of sharing with your different school partners come together and celebrate all at once? And maybe just have a little kind of 15-minute round robin thing. It builds community, but it also shows the school system that you're interested in culture change and bringing people together, globalization kind of stuff. Anybody did I forget anything, guys? Is that good? Oh, any questions? Sorry. Any questions about school programs and going in? You're welcome.
Hire for diversity and train for assimilation. Yeah, I heard, full disclosure, that was the executive director of YWCA in Boston, and she said that in a panel discussion, and it felt so true that all of these conversations that we're having about EDI work, and how many white folks are entering that conversation, and it's suddenly a concern that the culture of our organizations are still not changing. And so we're all really concerned about diversity, but doing nothing, right? It's the hands that Nicole, that cartoon that she showed us earlier, that we don't want to change, but we want to have a diverse staff, and you can't have it both ways.
Then we had a discussion about language competency, how you start to integrate different ways to train your staff on what language development sort of looks like in a classroom if you're working with dual language learners or you have dual language teachers. Universities are a great resource. We'll write some of those resources down as well. What else? What did I miss, you guys?
Like 5 pages of notes.
I took so many notes, I'm sorry. And we didn't get them all up. Something that Jennifer said that was a really sort of, I think, important thought that she put into our discussion is, she said, you need to think about the layers that the students have to walk through to get to you. And then think about how many layers you've walked through to get to them. That we need to all sort of look at ourselves and our staffs and our organizations and make sure that we are meeting them halfway instead of asking them to come all the way to us. And then the other big discussion we had is on how to create space that is for everybody and how to sort of educate the gatekeepers, the teachers, and the different sort of adults that come into your space that have their own ideas on what is appropriate theater behavior, et cetera. And that was, I don't know if anybody wants to jump in on that conversation, but.
I would say just like, yeah, and asking yourself as an organization, how can I make a welcoming space? Do I need to change something? How much space do you hold as well when you are going into communities that aren't yours? Like, how much actual space are you holding? How to be honoring with how you are? Like, there was a really key moment today too when I think Nicole sat down, and that's like an interesting example of how she was holding the space for us and the power.
Um,
Yeah.
Great. First step is how do you start? So one of the questions came up of really how do you start to have a conversation, and something that had a lot of energy around it was the listening, of how really to be present inside the listening, and not assuming what the collaboration will be, but really figuring out what it is. And then ask the base came up again, find out what you need to bring to the table. What is the knowing, really knowing what your organizational reputation is in the community, and maybe that might help to bring some of that down, bring that to the conversation. Bear witness, just for our notes, I wasn't sure the proper bear in this
and then that there's
synergy of what do we want to do and need, and then what do they want to do and need, and how we come together in that conversation for synergy, and then we might end up living here.
Skill set, what do they need, relationship, community.
Right, I love that, relationship and community.
Should I wear jeans or a dress?
I'm sure.
Because I'd want to crawl through a tunnel. Right. I brought jeans.
Museum like any other museum you've ever been. It's, and there are places
There's a what?
So I just want to share night. A few other announcements and observations. I want to thank all of you. This has been an extraordinary day. It was really planned with a very large planning committee, and I want to thank the planning committee. There were a lot of members of the planning committee here in the room. Thank you for all your time and helping to craft this agenda. Maybe pick up our chairs and help put them back. And with that, thank you.